Hey, how you doing? I'm Pastor Kat. This is your weekly encouragement. Each and every book of the Bible has a certain flavor to it, and today is no exception. We are in the book of James. Whenever I think of the book of James, I think of that perfect father figure, the father we wish we all really had. All the advice that James gives is not only practical, but terribly pithy, the kind of thing you can hold on to that actually changes you heart, mind, and soul. And today I got a passage I have to share out of James chapter 1. It says, James, a bondservant of God and the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes who were dispersed throughout, greetings. Consider it all joy, my brethren, when you encounter various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces endurance, and endurance has its perfect result, so that you may be perfected, complete, and lacking in nothing. I don't know about you, but for me, if I knew that I could be complete and lacking in nothing, I would do all that I could to chase it. And here, James says the trials and the tribulations in your life are one of those things that leads you to that perfection that we all seek. Now, of course, perfection only comes from Christ, and so the trials have to be about that. Trials that I bring on myself perhaps don't count, at least not in the way James has framed it here. Now, he goes on, and it gets very interesting. In verse 5, it says, but if any of you lack wisdom, let him ask God, who gives to all generously and without reproach, and it will be given to him. But he must ask in faith without doubting. The one who doubts is like surf on the sea, driven and tossed by the wind. For that man ought not to expect that he'll receive anything from the Lord, being a double-minded man, unstable in all of his ways. That's the second thing I wanted to implore everyone today, and that is those of us who are lacking wisdom. This isn't knowledge, this is wisdom. This is like applied knowledge. If you're not sure exactly what it is you should be doing next in your life, you feel like you have all the information you need, but you still have a choice to make. We're called by James to ask God for that wisdom to make those choices. As long as we're not double-minded, being fully aware of the fact that God will provide it, not like the surf on the sea that comes and goes, then God promises to give us that wisdom. Talk about a huge promise from the Father. And the third piece, he goes on with one more piece of wisdom, and it says this, verse 9, but brothers, of humble circumstances is the glory of his high position, and the rich man is to glory in his humiliation, because like flowering grass he'll pass away. The sun rises with a scorching wind and withers the grass, and its flower falls off, and the beauty of its appearance is destroyed. So too is the rich man in the midst of his pursuits will also fade away. This is good news for those of us who struggle financially. We know that we can glory in those humble circumstances. And for those of us that have a lot, we know that having a lot can lead to this specific humiliation, because all things pass away. And the reason this comes to my mind today is because on my hike I found something very interesting. You may have noticed that today we are actually standing in what was a log cabin with a beautiful view. The view is still beautiful because God's majesty still reigns. I'll show you the view at the end. But ultimately speaking, even something that had this much effort and this much work put into it, eventually it all crumbles and falls, just like the flowers of the field. Well, I hope this has been as encouraging to you as it has been to me. God bless. We'll see you next week.